To the latest on a Border Patrol shooting that happened last May on the Tohono O'odham Nation, Raymond Matia was shot 9 times by agents. An earlier report by Customs and Border Protection stated agents felt threatened when he threw a machete at them. News 4 Tucson's Lupita Murillo attended a news conference today where family members, along with their attorneys, say they're going to take legal action. Lupita has been covering this story since it all began and has the latest right now. Lupita.
The news conference was held outside of the federal courthouse here, and the family, through their attorney, say they are disappointed with the Department of Justice and their handling of this tragic case. We want to warn you, the video you're about to see, some of you may find disturbing.
This body cam video released by Customs Border Protection after the investigation was complete shows 58-year-old Matia throwing a machete at the agents. Then, when Matia comes out, he has his hands in his pocket. He complies and then is shot multiple times. His niece, Yvonne Nevades, addresses the crowd. She says her uncle's death is a great loss to the family and the community.
Justice for Ray! Justice for Ray!
The edited video released by CBP promoting their justification for shooting Ray leaves many unanswered questions. We, as Ray's family, want and deserve answers concerning what happened to him.
Nevades goes on to say they believe Matia was approached with excessive and deadly force.
The agents went in with guns drawn as if walking into a war zone with family homes in close proximity. We are thankful that Ray's children were not there at the time because the outcome could have been far more tragic.
Ryan Stitt is one of the civil rights attorneys representing the family.
The Department of Justice does not plan to hold the agents accountable. And the Department of Justice will not even honor the family's rights as victims of a crime to answer basic questions about what led to Ray's death.
He adds they invited the Department of Justice to appear at the news conference.
They've chosen to remain silent in protection of the agents who killed Ray and in defiance of their obligation to the public to truthfully answer the questions about what led to his death.
Given all that's happening, he announced today they would be seeking legal action against the federal government.
Ray's murder demands change, demands accountability, and we intend to file a civil rights lawsuit against Customs and Border Protection. We delivered our formal notice to Customs and Border Protection of our intent to sue them, and it is up to them now to decide how to respond.
We reached out to the U.S. Attorney's Office and sent them 3 separate emails. We've not heard back. We also reached out to CBP. They did respond, and they said they would be getting back to us. Well, I'm looking at my emails here, and I've not received anything from CBP as of yet. But when I do receive something, we'll let you know what they say. Reporting live from the federal courthouse, Lupita Murillo, News 4 Tucson.